Allahu Akbar.
Welcome to our audience that is viewing from home during this lockdown. My name is Kashmir Miriam and this is my sister Aisha. Aisha, would you like to introduce yourself and what we do as the Strangers Organization?
Yes, assalamu alaikum, bismillahi wa salatu wa salam ala rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My name is Aisha and I am part of an organization called The Strangers, and our goal is to revive the message of Islam, and we do this through different means. One of the means is through spoken word poetry, through the collective voice of Muslim poets around the world, and just being able to clear up misconceptions. So that's our main goal. Yes, Kashmir.
Yeah, excellent. Jazakallah khair. So the work that we do as The Strangers is we host a lot of poetry slams. A lot of the time they're in person, and so we have our poets go up on stage, they compete for trophies and prizes, and we just have a good time. It's basically to platform the Muslim voice so that we can portray the true message of Islam through the art of spoken word poetry. So it's a creative art. It's something that is powerful and empowering. And that's what we wanted to do for you today. So we have a great show lined up for you all. We hope that you enjoy watching. And I just wanted to clarify a few things that are a little bit different about slam poetry versus written poetry or any other type of poetry, Shakespeare, whatever type of poetry you are into. So the difference between slam poetry is that it is about the content of the poem. So how deep is the lyrical content? How relevant is it to the audience? How powerful is the methods that are used to articulate what is being said in the poem? And second of all, the powerful thing about slam poetry, and probably one of the more important traits of slam poetry, is that it is heavily about the way in which the message is revealed to the audience. So it's not just about reading from a sheet of paper, it's about how that message is delivered. So that's something that we put a lot of emphasis on as The Strangers, and we do with all of our poets as well. So inshallah, today you'll be hearing some slam poetry, and I hope that you enjoy the show and all of the poets that we have lined up. There are three simple rules that we have for the poets. That is, number one, the content has to be appropriate, so no curse words. There is no inappropriate content, and our poets do understand that. The second rule is that we have to make sure that the poem is under 5 minutes. And number three is just to be respectful of everyone that is up there performing. Everyone is sharing something that is meaningful to them, and that's something very personal, and we have to respect that because that's very sanctified. So without any further ado, I would like to introduce our judge for this evening. Her name is Tahani Salah. Is Tahani there?
I'm here.
Assalamu alaikum, Tahani. How are you doing?
Alhamdulillah, we're doing good.
Perfect. So I have Tahani, your bio here. I'm just going to read it. And hopefully that will explain to everyone your background in poetry. I personally know Tahani from before. She's a slam poet, so she knows a thing or two, or more than a thing or two, about performance. And that's one of the reasons we chose to have her on our platform today. And that's something that means a lot to us, because I think to be a writer is one thing, but to be a performer is something else. So jazakallah her for joining us today. So Tahani Salah is an educator, poet, and activist based in Brooklyn, New York, with a bloodline to Palestine. She's a graduate of Columbia University, a former professor of curriculum development at the CUNY Graduate Center. She's also a member of the New Yorican Slam team. She competed internationally and holds many slam titles from Europe to Africa. Tahani has also been featured on HBO's Deaf Poetry Jam. She is passionate about peace and activism and carries that into the classroom as an educator, showing how life creates art and using it all as a tool of expression. As an artist dedicated to bringing light and solutions to communities where people's voices have been silenced, Tahani has performed at a number of world famous stages, including the Apollo Theater in New York City, to universities in the US, South Africa, Germany, Canada, Palestine, Jordan, and many more. Mashallah. Okay, so Tahani, you told me to pick one or two lines from your bio, but I felt like everyone needed to hear that. So welcome.
Okay, next person up, inshallah, is Sister Sarah Ali. Is Sister Sarah Ali here?
Okay. Yes, I am.
Sister Sarah, so please introduce yourself.
My name is Sara Ali. I'm 14 years old. I was born and raised in America, specifically in New York, Queens. But my parents, my family, they're from Palestine. And there's struggle happening there, war. And my poem's basically reflective on the idea that this world is basically corrupt and no one's really doing anything about it. So I hope you enjoy.
Jazakallah khair, sister.
Go the false it. Light of this world is only transparent to those who cause darkness to proceed. As people start to pass by those in the streets who we need to feed, fame and glory starts to unravel on a scale of never-ending ambition. It starts to become a disease. As half this world is lost in wealth and the other in despair. Homeless on the streets amongst the borders of Times Square. Materialistic objects that we idolize in the hopes of fame. It becomes those who are aware that they try to tame. Delusions, the implements of society to get us to forget about things that are not fair. And as half of us are silent, speaking out almost becomes a dare. You hear a whisper of justice, it's followed by a glare. Finding hope to some becomes rare. You see, we the people are the lab rats of an experiment gone terribly wrong. You play the game of massacre and you win a bone. You succeed as the rest of the world is in a war zone. We the people are lost in the cycle of wealth, and ultimately we have become blind. Most of us are deluded by the newsroom lies. We start to get confused about who's a terrorist and who's not, who is the killer and who died because he rebelled against injustice and fought. We the people need to look around and see the dreading circumstances of countries like Palestine, where Zionists are attacking and having the world believe in their lies, where the world now believes that there's an Israel and that we should let them attack, when America is taking our taxes, giving it to Israel, and kicking back. Every traumatic, excruciatingly tragic and sorrowful event that circulates this globe. It's like there's a nail being banged right into my soul and I can hear it through my earlobe. I can hear the children screaming as if the ground is pulling them in alive. I can hear the people running for their very own lives and I look to the bloody ground where these stories lie. The story of how a little boy was bombed after he hugged his mom goodnight. How the mother hugged him very tight before closing the light and when not able to keep their eyes open for security and protection any longer, they were found dead, not alive. We the people have disunited ourselves in the hopes of money and wealth, sold our people to the enemy's hands and disregarded their health, played the game of innocence to isolate ourselves from the reality known as massacre and terror, walked through the maze of never-ending joy and sent a I don't care about anyone letter. We let the bloodshed of our own blood and we let death be the solution of so-called justice so that we may prevail, creating depression, intoxicating moments that we don't even realize and chasing after our own tails. Self-absorbed in our own sick mentalities and let ourselves be fooled. Fell into the devil's plan and from blood we create masses of pools. Segregation and fatalization continues to linger in the society that we are in. As people start to make excuses to enable themselves to continue with their sins, we the people need to stop the propagandas, the backlash, and oppression that we see today. We the people need to fix these problems with just one way. Unity, together, as one ummah, and through that we shall succeed. No matter your ethnicity or mine, together every mouth we shall feed. Unity and justice, that's the key. Because in the phrase, we the people, it's we, not me. Unity, that's the key. Thank you. That's it.
Jazakallah khair, sister. That was beautiful. Allahumma barik. That was very, very beautiful. And I love the fact in the end, you said, we the people, not just me. And it's a very, very powerful concept because, you know, when it's very relative as related to the concept of we the people in general being Americans, mm-hmm. Which was the original theme of the ICNA convention. And she definitely tied it in beautifully. I pray that more people benefited from your words and it was very beautifully written. Jazakallah khair for sharing, sister.
Thank you.
Inshallah.
I want to thank everyone here. I want to thank primarily for hosting us on their platform. Every single year when we host this, it's just an amazing success and I can say alhamdulillah from the bottom of my heart, I think this was phenomenally successful. So jazakallah khair. I want to say a special jazakallah khair to Hani for joining us, for doing the very, very difficult job of judging. It can never be.
Thank you so much.
May Allah reward you and you know, for taking the time out. You're also a mother, so you know, I know it's difficult juggling duties, so may Allah reward you for that. And do you have any closing remarks, Aisha?
I just wanted to say that alhamdulillah. May Allah bless all of the viewers for attending. I pray that we all benefited. amazing event without our poets. Now, saying that as well, I'm not sure if you can see me. Okay, you could see me now. No further ado, you can find The Strangers on Instagram. Our website is in the works, inshallah. So please do definitely follow up with more information about the Uyghur campaign, which is a current campaign that we're doing. We hope you enjoyed the letter, the final compilation. A lot of heart went into it from our poets. And thank you again to everyone. And of course, Sister Tahani, you did an amazing job. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And Ikna. Of course, Ikna.
And lastly, I just want to say the greatest thank you to all of our poets for contributing their pieces. Each one was mind-blowing and touched my heart, and I'm sincerely saying that as someone who's been to a lot of poetry slams and had a lot of poetry over the years, as Tahani and as Aisha can both attest to, we heard an amazing level of talent tonight. So may Allah reward you all. And yeah, I'm going to close it right there. And assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.